Good morning. This month's theme was about writing, planning your writing and planning all the components of your writing. Today's the last installment. So my name is Michelle Thompson. I'm your academic and legal coach, and I worked as a lawyer for many years, and now I work in academia and as a coach, and this involves lots and lots of writing. I've learned a lot about it, and I want to share what I've learned with you in the last decade every Friday around 10:30 a.m. So my tip this week is to put your writing objectives in your calendar. So April's theme has been to plan your writing. And many of us in academia are starting to see the beginning of the end of the semester, right? We have a whopping 12 glorious weeks ahead without teaching responsibilities, many of us. But it's only 12 minutes. And that's the length of a semester, no more. So don't forget that you will have to prep your fall courses, take a break and manage other things. And last week I talked about subdividing your projects and managing the revise and resubmits to leverage what you do. This week, I'm going to talk about the importance of putting these goals into your calendar, putting your objectives in your calendar so you know what you're doing when. It's important for two reasons. When you sit down to write, the muse will always show up, right? That's why you have to schedule appointments with the muse to get her to show up to help you write. Secondly, you won't flail around trying to figure out what you're trying to do and burn through your time. So if you're using Wendy Laura Belcher's book, Writing a Journal Article in 12 Weeks, she has a built-in system for you to plan out what you're doing. And as a result, you can easily stick with the task that you're dealing with every day in a week. But if you're in a different part of the writing process and you're juggling multiple items, then you have to be super clear about what you're working on when. I am currently working on revising a book review and a journal article at the same time. The overall due dates are in my calendar. The book review is due next Friday, and the revise and resubmit is actually due on June 1st. However, to make those due dates, I have to take the subparts and put those subparts in my calendar. Each critique has a particular time slot when I'm dealing with it. As I get the meatier parts of the critiques completed, I will actually have to spend less time on others because they are simpler. For example, on the book review today, I finish working on the contents of each chapter. Once I do that, I rework the conclusion. I know that in advance, so that way when I sit down, I don't spend time futzing around trying to figure out what to do. So I've walked you through chunking out your work, making your writing actually bite-sized pieces. But after you do that, simply take those chunks and schedule them. It saves you time and frustration. Don't flail around. Make sure the writing muses are there when you sit down. Schedule what part of your writing you're working on any given day. All right? So if you have any questions about that, you can always send me a note. I love supporting people to schedule their writing. If you haven't before, go ahead and like the page and sign up for my newsletters and my comments. So I will be swift, be sharp. So long. Have a great weekend and happy writing.